Hare Krishna. Question: is the mode of goodness necessary for the practice of bhakti? Normally we say that bhakti is transcendental. So why do we need to be in mode of goodness to practice bhakti? Answer: the mode of goodness is not necessary to initiate bhakti, but it is necessary to sustain bhakti. What does that mean? That means that a person can even be a drunkard, and a person can chant and dance and sing, and that way practice from bhakti. So a person can be any sort of in any lower mode, even in the lowest of ignorance, that person can easily eat prasad. So the person can practice bhakti in terms of starting the practice from any mode, but over a period of time one needs to not just do bhakti occasionally, but if it's to be transformational, then it has to be done regularly. And regularity and discipline are characteristics of the mode of goodness. Now, in the mode of passion and ignorance, one is basically driven by one's attachments. And one may be very regular and disciplined, one may say, in terms of drinking alcohol, if you are considering alcoholic. But that is not an exercise of willpower. That is a exercise of abandoning one's willpower and succumbing to one's attachment. In goodness, one discriminates, understand this is good, this is bad, and this is what I should do. Even if it doesn't feel good right now, I'll continue doing it. So goodness is what will enable us to sustain the practice of bhakti, because in goodness we can subordinate our emotion to our reason. In passion and ignorance, we can't do that much. So in bhakti, we may get taste occasionally. So even a person who is alcoholic may find taste in dancing, but that's not what the person will find always. And the person in ignorance, when okay, dancing in kirtan feels boring, will give it up. But a person in goodness will understand that by purification I will get a higher taste, even if there doesn't seem to be any taste right now. And in that way, a person in goodness can sustain the practice of bhakti using reason. So material emotions can be subordinated to reason, and one can sustain one's actions. Sarvadvareshu deheshmin prakasham upajayate. Krishna says in 14.11, the characteristic of mode of goodness is illumination. So illumination means one has knowledge by which one can understand what is desirable and what is undesirable. In not just in terms of what our desires tell us, but in terms of what are the consequences in the long run. So anybody can start bhakti in any mode, but to sustain bhakti requires discipline, which in terms requires subordinating our feelings to our intelligence, which is a characteristic of the mode of goodness. So that's why the mode of goodness is important in the practice of bhakti. Now, when we say mode of goodness, we shouldn't think necessarily that it means changing our entire nature. You know, it's not that if a person has a Vaishya propensity, that person has to become a Brahmana to practice bhakti. No, even the Vaishya activities can be done in a passionate way, can be done in an ignorant way, or can be done in a goodness way. So when a person is Vaishya and is motivated primarily by greed and is even ready to hurt others for the sake of getting money, that sort of activity is characterized by lower modes, passion and ignorance. But when a person may be a Vaishya, and it's not that the person can by the practice of bhakti become a Brahmana, not necessary. The person may continue business, and that's what the person's liking will be, talent will be, but the person will conduct business in a goodness way. That means with regulation by scripture, with moderation, with concern for others also. So basically, the way the mode of goodness will be expressed in different people will vary. So Vaishya, when we say is in the mode of passion, now that is talking about just the nature of the Vaishya. But that Vaishya, if agrees to follow scripture, then there is a level of goodness even in that. And if one starts practicing bhakti, then that goodness can take one towards transcendence. So we should not think of that coming to goodness necessarily means that we have to all abandon our innate nature and we have to just artificially act in a goodness sort of way. No, we can act according to our nature. In fact, that's what the Bhagavad Gita tells us. Svakarmana tam abhyarcha siddhim vindati manava. So here we see that the Bhagavad Gita tells that svakarmana, do your work but worship that Supreme Lord by the work that we are doing. So what Krishna tells here is that we don't have to change our occupational duty from ignorance to goodness or from Shudra to Brahmana to practice bhakti. But then Krishna also says that Raga Dvesha Vimuktaistu Vishayan Indriyeshcharan Atma Vashair Vadhaya Atma Prasadam Adigachati. In 2.64 he says that we put aside our attachment and aversions and follow scripture, Vidheya Atma. So following, coming to the goodness essentially means doing our duties but in accordance with scripture. So acting according to our nature but not letting that nature completely dominate all our actions. We harmonize the actions within that nature according to scripture and in accordance with devotion. And that way, we can be in the mode of goodness while being faithful to our material nature and also being faithful to the path that will awaken our spiritual nature and help us to find eternal happiness and love for Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.